It is New Year's Day, 1967, on the Dark Railway, and as usual, Dave, Brian and Raymond can be found at Gannon Junction, recovering from the previous night's New Year's Eve party, which was dreadful. Dave is feeling especially happy, as he now has a special coat of paint, as he was explaining to his two best friends. So, Mr. Dark told me that I'm to pull a special train on the main line in a few days' time, so he arranged for me to be painted in this special livery just for the occasion. I'll admit, the green paint with black and white stripes does suit you, but why have you got Dark Railway written on your tender? Mr. Dark says it's advertising the railway. No? Yeah. So that more people come to the railway and see us. When they see me roaring down the main line or stopped at a station, they'll see the Dark Railway logo and think, ooh, we must go there. And hopefully they'll come and see the railway for themselves. Brian and Raymond were highly doubtful that this would work, but Dave was confident about his new logo. The day before he was due to take this special train, the station master hurried over to see him and his crew. Oh, thank goodness you're still here, Dave. The diesel has failed at Raxus Heath, and we need someone to bring the diesel and its train back to the junction. Can you please go? Of course we can. Come on, Dave. No hanging about. But I'm comfortable. You can have a long rest when you get back. You'll need it before you go on your journey tomorrow. But no buts. Come on. So Dave rolled out of the yard and toward the main line, feeling cross with his crew and at the failed diesel. It wasn't a long journey, and soon Dave rolled cautiously into Raxus Heath station, where a small blue diesel was standing silently at the head of an empty wagon train. Dave saw that the engine looked thoroughly depressed, and he couldn't be cross. He buffed up to the failed diesel. Oh, thank you. Thank you ever so much for rescuing me. I'm blocking the line and I've overheated. Never mind, eh? These things happen, I suppose. You bound for Gannon Junction, then? Yes, I was, actually. Why? Huh. The junction's only a mile from here. Don't worry, I'll see you there, all right? All right. Dave soon hauled the engine and his train back to the junction. He shunted the train away and took the diesel to the sheds. They were quiet for a while, but soon they started chatting away as if they'd known each other for years. The diesel introduced himself as Kammer, and both began relating stories to each other. Dave found him very easy to talk to, but something was unusual about him. So, how come you're working on your own? I thought Class 20s usually worked in pairs. It's not a very nice story. Why? I used to work with my twin brother. His name was Jason, and we went everywhere together. But 3 months ago, we'd arrived at Southampton Docks with a goods train, and Jason decided to go and collect another train ready for our return journey. Well, as he crossed some points, another train came out of nowhere and hit him. His driver perished, and he was taken away and sent for scrap. Kammer looked rather distressed, but regained his composure quickly. So yes, that's why I've been working alone. But British Rail didn't like that. This was supposed to be my last revenue-earning service today. They say I'll be withdrawn next week. But that's not on! You're a young diesel. Surely British Rail don't want to go scrapping diesels. They've already started killing us steam engines. This is true. But if I were you, I wouldn't worry about us diesel. It's the electrics you've got to worry about. Dave said no more. He felt awful for Kammer and his situation. It was lucky that Kammer stayed at the junction that night, otherwise Dave would have been on his own the following morning. Though still feeling bad about Kammer, he was feeling very excited about his special mainline train. He waited impatiently in the yard, waiting for his train to arrive so that he could take over. Shortly, a big diesel rolled into the junction with coaches, and Dave headed off to take charge. Goodbye, Kammer. Hopefully I'll see you when I get back. I wouldn't bank on it. Good luck, though, Dave. Dave was running along the main line very fast indeed. He was enjoying himself greatly. The passengers hadn't complained, and the coaches rode very smoothly behind him. Presently, he arrived at a station, where he was due to stop for a short while. who didn't recognise the place at all and wondered where he was. He decided to ask the EMU in the platform next to him. "Excuse me, but where exactly am I?"
"On my turf, that's where."
"How rude!"
"Well, it's rude of you to still exist."
"Now hang on a moment, the likes of your kind have ousted steam from the mainline by force."
"Your kind have been ousted because you're dirty, slow and difficult to service. Us electric units are sleek, powerful and reliable. Nothing ever happens to us."
"But..." Before Dave could finish his reply, the guard blew his whistle and his driver opened his regulator. Dave sped away from the station feeling very cross indeed. He still didn't know what the station was called. Later that evening, Dave arrived back at Gallon Junction. He was tired and glad to have finally arrived home. Mr. Dark was waiting for him on the platform. "Good evening, Dave. I trust you had a good day."
"Yes, sir."
"Excellent. I hope my plan worked. Hopefully your passengers will have noticed the logo on your tender and come up here for a visit." Dave said nothing. He was exhausted. Mr. Dark then turned to the station master and began to speak to him. Dave was just about to move off when he caught a few words of Mr. Dark's conversation. "I'll be off looking for a new goods engine tomorrow." Dave had suddenly remembered Kammer. Could he potentially persuade Mr. Dark to buy him? "I've had a very interesting offer from..." Sir, I know of a goods engine you can buy. He's right here in the... Dave looked quickly to the yard, but Kammer wasn't there. Looking slightly cross, Mr. Dark looked at Dave. "How many times have I told you not to meddle in my business? Now go to the sheds and have a rest. That's a good engine. Now, as I was saying before that rude interruption..." Dave decided not to try and argue. He slunk away to the yard, feeling depressed, as well as exhausted. He spent most of the evening thinking about Kammer, and wondering how many other diesels like him were going to meet their end soon, along with the steam engines that they had been designed to replace. It bugged him something rotten over the next couple of weeks, and he got crosser and crosser with British Rail by every day. One evening, Dave found himself alone at Gallon Junction once again. He was just about to close his eyes and go to sleep when he heard the sounds of a diesel nearby. He opened his eyes and was surprised to see a diesel backing into the sheds. He was even more surprised when he realised it was a Class 20. "Kammer? Is that you?" "Oh, hello, Dave. I bet you're surprised to see me again. But, what are you doing here? I thought you had been withdrawn and scrapped." "I very nearly was. The day you took your mainline special, I was dragged down to Coalhapper to await my eventual return north. But the shed foreman took pity on me and arranged for Mr. Dark to come and see me. He bought me from British Rail and sent me to the work to be refurbished. So here I am." Dave was thrilled with this unusual turn of events and spent the rest of the night reassuring Kammer that he would be welcomed by the rest of the engines when he finally got around to meeting them. Kammer went to sleep a few hours later, feeling happier than he had done for a very long time.